Good morning, everyone. So today's assignment is being posted a little bit later than it normally is because I wanted a chance to speak to my class before I went ahead and posted it. I had a couple questions about the assignment, wanted to make sure it made sense before I put it out there. So yesterday you watched a video about colonies and the Mayflower Compact, and you talked, hopefully you did your homework for me, which was to write in a Google Docs that you, what would you would do if you were there to sign the Mayflower Compact? What would you think of as solutions, or what would you anticipate as challenges that you would have to meet as you were setting up your new colony? So if you did not do that and submit the document to me, you need to make sure that gets it done. For today, we're really going to dig into the 13 colonies. These were the first colonies that were established and actually was able to sustain itself. Well, what that means is there were other colonies, like we talked about the Lost Island of Roanoke. People that came there, something happened, right? They were gone. They weren't able to sustain their life. Something wiped them all out. We don't know what it was, but there were definitely times that people who were exploring started colonies, and for whatever reason, they didn't last. They either moved on and went back, or they died because they didn't have enough food or they didn't have shelter. So what we're looking at with the 13 colonies is the establishment of colonies that actually are able to be continued. So they are the 13 colonies that were started for different reasons, and we're going to talk about that in our research. But these colonies are the 13 that actually were able to be established and be able to maintain and keep going. And they actually end up becoming the first beginnings of what we now know as the United States. So we're going to take it step by step, and we're going to look at, you can see on my slide here that the 13 colonies were here part of the East Coast, and they run up and down from Maine to Florida. You are going to start today looking at the Northern colonies or the New England colonies, and you're going to look at the Connecticut, Rhode Island, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, and Maine is actually part of it, but Maine was actually considered to be part of Massachusetts. So you're going to look at those colonies here today and look at what those things were affected. So looking at today's assignment, I have a couple of videos for you to look at, and I have a couple of documents for you to read. They're going to be a little bit of information for you to take in. You're going to have to read through them and listen to the videos. The information that I'm asking for you is not going to be a quick one line, oh, there's the answer, just put it in. It's very much like our activity that we did with our explorers, where you have to read, synthesize, think, and with that process, you will be able to answer the questions that I'm asking you and ask, be able to provide that information. So looking at what your activity is, it's going to be an ongoing activity for the whole week. Today, you're starting with the northern colonies. You'll work with the middle colonies tomorrow. Thursday will be the southern colonies, and Friday will be an activity about all of the 13 colonies. So today, you're going to watch the videos, read the text, and you're going to fill in the information about the climate, the landforms. Landforms, again, are mountains, rivers, waters, things that are there by nature. What is there for them? That becomes really important as you look at that geography. If the river is there, or if there's an ocean by, or if there's mountains, it may matter with what kind of successes they have. In terms of the climate, we know that New England is very different than the South, so we want to make sure we're thinking about that as we're looking at what kind of hardships they might have faced. The economy, I'm asking you to look at what kind of crops are going to grow there. Certainly the things that are going to grow well in the South are not necessarily the things that are going to grow well in the North. So looking at those different crops, ways that they are going to be able to provide food for themselves and maybe make an income. And then the types of jobs that they were doing. Definitely, you're going to see different things between the South, the Middle, and the Northern colonies. So just making a quick note around that, and it does say all this information in the videos and in the text. So Massachusetts, you see there's two pages here for Massachusetts. One is the Bay Colony. You can see that that is one part of Massachusetts. And then the Plymouth Colony, that takes up a different part. They actually become Massachusetts as a total, but those colonies are very different and they're founded for different reasons. So I'm asking you to tell me who founded them, what year they were founded. I don't need to know the month. I don't need to know the day, just the year. And what was the purpose? So why did those people go and start that colony? Did they come from Europe directly and started that colony? Or did they come from a different colony and they starting their own way of life? So I'm asking you to complete those three things about each colony that we talk about. So Massachusetts has two. You're going to look at New Hampshire, Connecticut, and Rhode Island today, and you're going to provide for me the reasons why they became a colony, who started that colony, and when they started. That is your assignment for today. Tomorrow, I will give you another document, and you will end up putting them all together, but it will be the middle colonies, and you'll do the same thing where you're researching the information about the middle colonies and completing the document. You need to submit this to me when you are done. I want to keep track of everything that you're doing and see that you actually complete the task. And that's the reason why I'm not doing it as one big document. We're doing them as separate documents because I want to be able to see, yes, Mrs. Hickey, I finished this region. Okay, if you have questions, please reach out. I think this is pretty clear. This is going to take you a little bit of time, and that's the reason why it's going to be something we do over the course of the rest of the week. Friday, if you're not done these or you feel like you need to add a little more, or if I've given it back to you to add some information or check your data, that will be your data. Sort of clean those things up, make sure they're all submitted, and I will have probably one question or two questions for you to answer based on your research. And it may not be, you know, what year was something founded, but more of some thinking questions, applying the information that you've come up with, putting together some information and really thinking through a problem or a question. So that will be your Friday assignment. Make sure you're continuing to do your science for this week. That also will be due on Friday. It's simply the observation about something decomposing on your counter. If you have questions about that, please let me know. You don't need to submit that until the end of the week when it is done. Otherwise, this is your ongoing assignment, and we will touch base. Again, I'm here from 12:30 to 1:30. Questions, reach out, and certainly don't let things just keep going, friends. If you're struggling, you're not sure, ask the question. I would rather you ask than find yourself so far behind that it's hard to catch up. So I miss you guys, and that's all we have for today.